Let's make an American flag cake together.
This patriotic cake is made up of strawberry cake layers and white cake layers and covered in a delicious buttercream. Perfect for your next July 4th celebration.
You are going to need a total of 4 layers in order to build this American flag cake. 1 white layer, 1 blue layer, and 2 red layers. You're going to have some leftover cake scraps because we're going to have to do a little bit of trimming and we're going to have to use a round cutter on some of the pieces. But that's okay. Cake scraps are great. They make a great trifle. They also can be made into cake pops. Make just a snack on them. They're good, but you're going to need 4 layers.
For the first red cake layer, we're going to take it and trim off the top so it's nice and level on the top and then split the cake layer in half. I use a serrated knife to trim up my cakes. That's one of these knives, you probably already know this, but that has the little jagged edge. Now that I have this layer nice and even, I'm gonna split it in half.
One layer,
put it
on my rack.
Other layer,
also going on the wire rack.
I'm gonna repeat the same process with the second cake layer by trimming the top and then splitting it in half.
Here we go.
All the way through. This comes into play right now, so I'm gonna take that 4-inch cutter and I'm gonna cut a cake circle out of one half of my red layers. This portion, with the hole cut out, we'll save for another use. This portion will be part of the cake that we're building. We're moving on to working with this white cake layer. Similar to the red layer, I'm gonna trim the top and split it in half. Again, I'm using my serrated knife. And I'm doing it on a cake turntable, which really just kind of helps. If you deal with a lot of cake, you might want to invest in one of these. Some folks would trim the edges too. I'm not going to do that because I don't want to, but it does make it prettier when you slice it out if you cut off all this. Now I'm going to split this white cake layer in half the same way I did with the red layers. Look at that. I'm going to take this half and put it over here with all my red layers. I'm going to take this same 4-inch cutter and I'm going to cut a circle out of this white cake layer. In this piece, we will save for another use. We're going to trim this blue layer and cut a circle out of it. We do not split this layer in half. So I'm just going to kind of trim the dome off of the top of this blue layer. Look at that. Trimming off this bottom layer of the blue because it's so dark. That's just the way it bakes. It's just the nature of it. It doesn't have to be perfect. Yay! For the blue layer, we've got to cut this center out with that 4-inch cutter and save that center for another use. Now we're cutting through a whole cake layer, not a half, so it's a little bit trickier. Save this piece that looks oddly like a little scrubby sponge. Save this for another use. This layer will be the top of our American flag cake. Now for the fun part. Let's build this cake layer by layer. It's super easy to do. You'll have to figure out what to do with those leftover cake scraps, but I promise you this is gonna be fun. We're gonna start with layer 1, one of our red cake caps. When it comes to icing cakes, I feel like I've done a million at this point. I like to use an ice cream scoop to distribute the icing between the layers because that helps me keep the amount that I'm doing in between each layer pretty even. As we build this cake, we're gonna put icing in between the layers and then we'll do a crumb coat on the outside before we finally get into making it pretty on the outside so you can surprise all your guests on the 4th of July when you slice into this thing. Look at that mess. Here we go. And then you add another half of the red layer. That feels like a bigger scoop than I did on the other layers. Here's what we've got so far. We've got a red layer half, a white layer half, and another red layer half. And now we're gonna go for the blue layer. I'm gonna put this blue layer on top. The blue layer that has the hole cut out of it. You can see how even it is. We're looking pretty good. And what I'm gonna do is ice this part and inside the blue layer. Look at that, I've got the inside iced, and next up, our last two pieces of the puzzle are going in. This is our white cake circle, and I'm just gonna kinda plug it into the center, carefully, of this blue cake that we cut out. I'm gonna add just a smidge of icing on top. smidge. Last piece going in. Careful. I just need to crumb coat this and get it into the fridge for at least 15 minutes before I put the final touches on it. I've got my crumb coat on and I'm about to stick this in the fridge and let it chill, literally, while I kind of clean up and get ready to make it beautiful. It is ready to be frosted, so let's just get right into it. Creamy, this buttercream. One section to go. Can we do it? I'm gonna transfer this onto a cake plate and then we'll add sprinkles last. This part makes me sweat. Transfer was a success. Let's add sprinkles. Look at these little patriotic cuties. They're going right on the top. Has all kinds of little gold and stars. So cute. Let's get a slice out of this so I can show y'all what the inside looks like. The flavors are delicious. The red layers are strawberry, the white layers are white cake, and as is the blue layer. Look at that. This patriotic cake is so much fun to make. It's like putting a puzzle together, but in the form of cake. How fun is that? I hope y'all enjoyed this, and I'm gonna try to see how it tastes.